Well, hey folks, Ryan here, up here with John Flynn, Matt Young, my son's Michael and David, privileged to serve the worship of the Lord this morning by sharing his gospel. I just always like to take a few moments and do an apologetic. Why are we here and what are we doing? Why would we stand on the corner of Eugene in a place that didn't invite us to share the gospel with people? Is it because there's an enjoyment of fighting and mixing up and arguing? And the answer is 100% no. Because the reality is, we're so heavily burdened by the joy of the gospel. We pray every day, Luke 10:2, pray to the Lord of the harvest, to send workers into the field. As the harvest is ready, the workers are few. We believe that the gospel is the power of God for salvation. That it is the gospel that saves. Jesus calls. And the question is, what would happen if this was September 10th and we were taught to be people, 2,000 people who were about to enter the towers to work the next day? Would we stand here and just, you know, walk around and hope someone is, by us being nice, that someone comes up and asks us, what does it mean to face God in judgment, and what's the secret of eternal life? Or would we come in here and would we appeal to people to spend some time to think about the things of God? So we come to appeal to people. To think about that there will be a day to prepare for a person to die once and then to face judgment. And in that judgment day, if you have not spent time thinking about the things of God, it will be too late. So this is an invitation to talk to folks that we would not normally talk to about the beautiful saving faith of Jesus Christ. And so please know that we'll be doing this now for a little while here at Saturday Market. We'll be moving on to the University of Oregon football game. Please pray for us that we will shine the love of Christ and His light into this world, that the Spirit will be at work for us, giving us some peace, calm that transcends all understanding, giving the world a sin and drawing people to Himself.
So that means our view of love is inaccurate. So you need to get back and read the Bible. We need to read the Bible and use this version of the word love.
Already right now, people are hearing the gospel, and there are two gospel conversations happening. We've been here for 5 minutes. What a blessed experience.
You see, you can't take with you all the things in life. You can't take all these good things. It's a hard thing in America to share the gospel because we have so many things, so many insulators in our lives. We have hard work. We have good friends. We live basically at peace. We've been at peace as a nation for a long time. We've never been attacked on our own soil. The only place time we've been attacked, we've never defended off. So we have had nothing but peace. But God says there's going to be a day that's going to come when people exchange what was peaceful, we consider to be peaceful, for what is evil. God says that evil will come upon you. He says it will come upon you through the thieves in the night. And he says he sends people to warn a nation when it's in peril. He sends people to alarm. See, what happens is God, the people do what they want to do. So God says He's going to come and bring people around so that they will know. They will know that they're going to come and make it. God says He's good. He's good to warn people. He says that